The patient was very happy with the new restorations, even commenting that the results exceeded her expectations. To expose a bit more of the prep and protect the sulcus from excess cement, I pack a size 000 cord around both 7 and 10. If placing cord before cementation, ensure it's packed deep enough beyond the margins. Otherwise, cord getting trapped under your restorations would be a very bad day at the office. After try-in, we clean the restorations out with Ivoclean. We then apply a very thin coat of OptiBond Universal inside the restorations to act as a primer for the zirconia. Once the restorations are cleaned and primed, I begin prepping the teeth for bonding. I recommend using an adhesive resin cement with more translucent restorative materials, like BruxZir Esthetic, in the anterior. To disinfect the preps, I apply a very thin coat of Gluma, carefully avoiding the soft tissue. Then OptiBond Universal adhesive is scrubbed on both preps, air thinned, and cured. The restorations are loaded with clear cours NX3 adhesive resin cement and then seated into place. With a tack cure of about 3 seconds on the facial and lingual, the excess cement enters a gel state for easy removal. After flossing to remove any excess interproximally, we final cure for 20 seconds per surface. Well, that concludes the treatment process for this case. The patient was very happy with the new restorations, even commenting that the results exceeded her expectations. If you're seeking an uncompromising material for strength and translucency, BruxZir Esthetic is just that. I look forward to sharing more transformations with this amazing material in the future.